paper wire and hook it up. All right, moment of truth. I just hooked up the speaker wire to the back here. Can you see? There it is. I'll plug this in. In. Oh, freaking A, that was loud. Okay, all right. I'm gonna pair my phone really quickly and see how it goes. Up until this point, I'd been running this off of a DC power. It's up here. A little laptop charger that's 19 volts. Now, I've at least got it portable. So, I've rigged up, just connect a bunch of old wires that I, or an old adapters that I have. Made sure that I figured out which was positive and negative coming from the outlet. So I knew which one was positive and negative proper going into here. And now I've got the negative hooked in, and I marked them with just some, oh yeah, you saw that little spark. It should power on. Yes, it did. Play some music on it, see how it goes. That's a freaking crappy JB Weld, but a little flaky and gross. That's what you get when you get it on clearance. Anyway, let that harden up. Oh, that actually kind of worked. So, if I push this, I'm just going to release, hopefully. There we go. Cool. I've pushed it on and off a couple of times, so I'm going to keep this plastic on here. It's Christian.
Yeah.
Okay, he's unbolted those six bolts or four bolts. Four. Which ones are they?
They're these four.
Oh, right, those four over there. Okay. And black. Oh, well, it's easy because they're different sizes. So black, small, blue, big. Good. Hey, Elias. Tell me what you've done here.
I don't know.
Show me. Show me. What is this?
It's a holder.
It's a holder, right? Okay. Yeah. Now, what did you do? How'd you make said holder?
Screwed screws in this holder.
Okay, you screwed screws into the holder.
Yes.
What is this holder from? What'd you make that out of?
I don't know. Plastic.
Big piece of plastic.
Came out. It's over there. There's a big piece of plastic.
It came off of a radiator, Elias. Did you know that? Came off of a radiator. Alright, pull the battery out. Show us how this works. What does it do?
I don't know.
You don't know? Elias, you just built it. What do you mean you don't know? Good. Beautiful, dude. Hold on. Oh. Okay, now Elias, tell me how you made this.
I don't know.
Alright, had a couple kids from the neighborhood over here helping with this, and I'm kind of impressed by them. So this is going to be the battery holder, version 1. And it just fits within this old piece of plastic that was a radiator, and it fits perfectly. So one of the guys pulled off these, which are just prongs from an old cell phone charger, and I drilled a hole through it, and now let's see, there we go. Now they're dug in there. You can see them, the positive and the negative sides. I'm going to now epoxy putty. Using that putty, I'm going to put some epoxy putty in and seal them in place while keeping the metal exposed. We'll connect onto those at some other point. So, see how it goes. All the epoxy's in. Doesn't look pretty. I jammed it in there with a screwdriver. It looks as though my pins are still in place. Just gonna let this sit and come out and test it again tomorrow. There's no reason to move this battery out. Hey, got myself a some high density polyethylene in the shape of an old container. Boom. Cut that container apart and I end up with all these pieces. Now, I'm gonna take these pieces and somehow form something around my battery. Got the side of this radiator thingy here. And I just cut that right off. I'm gonna drill some holes right here to lock it in place. Go do that right now. All right, so these were the three builds that I had before I ended up with this one for my battery holder. I think I attempted this one first. The problem with it, and actually it probably would have worked out well, but the epoxy putty that I used was old, and you can see like the flecks in here that I wasn't able to get blended with the right consistency. So as a result, this didn't fully harden, and this is flexible and malleable, as you can see, and typically it wouldn't do that. But this was a good situation, a good solution. I just put a plastic bag over the top of the battery and then molded this around it, and it actually worked pretty well. I mean, it fit really almost perfectly. That was great. That was a great solution if it would have hardened properly, but it didn't, and I moved on. I was going to cut little holes in here. That's where we're going to stick something into to make contacts with the negative and positive terminals there, but went past on that. And then I went to this. And this is, I think, the second attempt. Second attempt at a battery holder. And it turned out good. It worked perfectly. It worked just as well as this one. The only problem was this side is not flat. So I couldn't mount it anywhere. And the way that I actually planned on initially mounting is something over here on the back of the speaker. And in the end, I just said, look, screw it. So I'm going to do this. I may as well do it with that one. But in between these two builds, see, we even had these holes drilled and tested. This was, these prongs were actually in it. I'd end up pounding these out later to see if I could reuse them here, but I couldn't. But this was perfect. It worked out really well. But this is just a better version of it. And then my final attempt was made using high-density polyethylene. The fit is okay. Let's see, I think this covers the entire battery, actually. So, comes in. The problem with this is that it's just not structurally super strong. I didn't get far enough into it because I realized pretty quickly that, first of all, this looked ugly. And second of all, I'd need to use some more HDPE, which would have been okay and fine. I just used my heat gun. Where's my heat gun at? Down there. Used my heat gun to get it to the melting point and formed it around it. It formed a good, decent mold. But it's not perfect. It slides out. I could have fixed that, I think, down the road. But this, once again, is a solution I think could work if I put a little bit of time and effort into it. I just lucked out by having this old piece of, I mean, this big piece of radiator, like, housing that happened to be the perfect width right here compared to my battery itself. So I'm going to fit in absolutely perfectly. So cutting at the right angles, and this could still be improved. I'm sorry, cutting at the right angles could help. And this still could be improved. Fitting in here is a little off. I do need to like press down on it before I slide it in. But I was trying to start this stuff up. So push down on the back end, get it to engage. There it goes. Thank you. This is my speaker, Bluetooth compatible. This is kind of version 1.8. So there are a few improvements that I can make, but I'm probably not going to. These are connected in okay. I soldered them in place and didn't do a very good job doing it. I don't like the wiring being external, but I didn't want to. I could have removed this plate and on the inside just soldered these wires directly to the board that these go to. I didn't want to do that, so I didn't. There's my amplifier, my Bluetooth board. Generally, it is working fine. Sounds pretty good. This cone, I think I mentioned, was pushed in. I was able to get a like a roll like this, put it in there, and just suck on it and pop it back out, which was kind of nice. Got it. Now we're talking. That worked. It performs fantastically given the price of everything. I mean, this speaker itself was $2 at a thrift shop. The awesome thing about it is it's lithium battery. They come from my drills, so those can be removed at any time and replaced and recharged. And this thing powers it. I'm not sure how long it powers it, but we've been listening to music all morning. I've had it up when it was wired up but not actually assembled. And I'd ran it for, you know, most of the day and didn't have any real problems with it. But the one other issue that I had was this could probably be spring-loaded. This is spring-loaded in my drills, and that's what kicks it out so quickly. So I could spring-load this if I wanted to kick the pack out, but I can just pull it out. It's not a big deal. This is a little unique. So this piece of plastic was just a piece of radiator that... So my radiator I had to replace in my car, and this plastic happened to be the perfect width of this. I tried a couple of different things to make this base, to make this plate, to make this battery holder, basically. I tried high-density polyethylene. I'll show you that. High-density polyethylene, and I also tried using epoxy putty, which I've been successful with in the past, using epoxy putty. But this epoxy putty that I purchased was a bad batch. It was old and flaky and didn't really form up. So honestly, that might be the easiest route. This was a little difficult, so we had to drill these holes in, put the screws in which hold the battery pack in place. And this is actually kind of fun. One of the kids from the neighborhood had the idea to do this, to engage the batteries. I think negative and positive terminal, so negative, positive. What he did was broke an outlet, just a plug, right? Something you plug into here, busted it, and then we drilled holes, epoxied it in place, and now that's how we connect it. It's something straight, but you know, it's good enough. Benny, knock it off! So, the way that it slides in, and it's got this little place drilled out to accept the clip. So, comes in here. Connected, we're clipped in. Oh, hey. And there goes the Bluetooth sound. So we're connected. And this is such a good, I mean, I could lift it with this. All I'm using is two little screws to hold this thing in. I think I might make a handle somewhere in the future, but that's it. The sound it pumps out is actually pretty decent. I can't remember how many watts my Bluetooth amplifier is. But I've got this Aomyus Go Bluetooth speaker, which is, I mean, for the money, I think the best that you can buy from what I've read. It's cheap. It's only like 70 or 80 bucks, but it's waterproof. And it kicks out pretty good sound. You can pair it with another one. You can pair it with two, which is kind of cool. But this one speaker... it's louder, the sound quality is good, except up to probably I mean, up at the higher volumes, the sound quality starts to distort and not get as good. But it's much louder than this one. And if you wanted to hook it up to a speaker with bass, it would be even better, I think. But there it is. All right, so the range on this thing is not fantastic. So what I'm going to do is take this about a little bit more than one and a half inch piece of just copper wire. It came from an old antenna that hooked up to a VCR or something. And I'm going to connect it here. This is the Bluetooth antenna. This leaves a lot to be desired. So I'm going to add this to here. And hopefully we'll get a little bit better reception on the Bluetooth. So I'm just going to go ahead and solder this really quickly. And I'll put some solder here. Some solder here, and then bring it together. Maybe. Well, I think it worked. That's good news. Before, I was only able to get, like, literally, if I pulled this thing just a little bit away from the speaker, it would stop. Now I'm, you know, halfway across the garage, and it works fine. So it was a success. Let's put a handle on this.